Hi students, welcome to Justine NCERT Solutions. In this video we are going to see 700 Maths Chapter 8 Comparing Quantities Introduction Part. In this chapter we are going to discuss the following chapters: Ratio, Equivalent Ratios, Conversion of Units, Percentage, Fraction to Percentage, Decimal to Percentage, Profit or Loss, then Simple Interest. Now we are going to see that first one, Ratio. The meaning of Ratio is equal to We are comparing two quantities. For example, ratio between boys and girls in 7th standard. Boys, girls. This symbol is called as is to. This symbol is called as is to symbol. B is to G. Boys is to G, that is for ratio. We can say that 10 boys, 12 girls, 10 is to 12. Boys and girls ratio. That is called ratio, and when we are comparing two quantities, definitely the quantity should be in the same unit. For example, here we are comparing students. We have to compare students and students only. We cannot compare students and animals. We cannot compare students and fruits. So the unit should be in same. Next, we are going to see that equivalent ratios. Equivalent ratios, we can compare that ratio of 7th standard, ratio of school. For example, boys and girls ratio in 7th standard 10 is to 12. Next, if school ratio also same, total school strength boys and girls, if it is same ratio, for example 100 is to 120, these two is called equivalent ratios. Why is it called equivalent ratios? If we simplify, both will be giving same answer. We are going to simplify this. 10 divided by 12. Next, here 100 divided by 120, we are going to simplify. 5 2s are 10, 6 2s are 12, so we can write it 5 by 6. Next, this side, 0, 0 gets cancelled. Again, we can simplify, 5 2s are 10, 6 2s are 12, and now 5 by 6. Before that, that total number of boys 10, girls 12. But total school strength, boys 100, girls 120. But when we are simplifying, ratios are equal. Ratios are equal, therefore these two ratios are called equivalent ratios. That value is not exactly equal, but ratio is equal, that's why this is called equivalent ratios. Next, we are going to see that conversion of units. Conversion of units is very important, because first, if we are mentioning solid shapes, mass, we can say that kilogram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram. If we are measuring that liquid, that will be liters. 1 kiloliter is equal to 1000 liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Next, if we are measuring distance, distance 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Next, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. This is mass, liquid. This is for solid shapes, solid. This is liquid, distance, and then time. Time also very important. 1 year is equal to 365 days. 1 month and we can say that 1 year is equal to 12 months also. 1 month is equal to approximately 30 days. Sometimes 1 or 2 months will have 31 days. So 1 month equal to 30 days. 1 day is equal to 24 hours. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. And 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So these are all the very important conversions. This is mass, or we can say it for solid. 1 kilogram, 1000 gram. 1 gram, 1000 milligram. Next, if it is liquid, 1 kiloliter is equal to 1000 liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. If it is distance, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Time, 1 year equal to 365 days. We can compare this 1 year equal to 12 months also. Next, 1 month is equal to 30 days. 1 day 24 hours. 1 hour 60 minutes. 1 minute 60 seconds. And 1 week. 1 week equal to 7 days. So these are all the important conversions. This is conversion of units. Next we are going to see that percentage. Now we are going to see that percentage. Percentage is the meaning of percentage. You can see that percentage words in many places, in bank or shopping mall, discount, everywhere you can see that percentage. 10% discount, 50% discount, 8% interest, like that you can see that everywhere percentage is available. Now we are going to see that what is called percentage, what is the meaning of percentage. This percentage word is derived from Latin word per centum. The meaning of centum, 100. The meaning of centum is equal to 100. Per 100. Everything is calculated per 100. That's why it is called percentage. Per centum. Per centum is a Latin word. Per 100. Centum is equal to 100. So per 100, what is the percentage? For example, if they are giving discount, 5% discount. The meaning of 5% per 100 rupees, 5 rupees is discount. So we will get 95 rupees. Per 100, 5% discount. If it is 1000 rupees or 1 lakh, crore, everything is comes under this percentage. Per 100 is 5%. We have to calculate for remaining amount. That is called percentage. Next, we are going to see that fractions to percentage. How to convert fractions into percentage? For example, I have 10 pence. Totally, I have 10 pence. I am going to give 5 pence to my friend. 5 divided by 10. This is in fraction. Now, how much percentage I have given to my friend? I have to find the percentage. To find that percentage, I have to multiply by 100. To find percentage, we have to multiply by 100%. This symbol we have to write it. 5 by 10 into 100% is equal to, we have to simplify. 10 gets cancelled. What is remaining? 5 into 10. 5 into 10 is equal to 50%. So I have given 50% of pencils to my friend. And next one, if we are having number like this, out of 8 notebooks, my friend have only 7 notebooks. Out of 8, 7 notebooks he bringing to the school. What is the percentage? The same thing, we have to multiply by 100%. 7 by 8 into 100% is equal to, we have to simplify here. We can simplify by 4. 25 4s are 100, 2 4s are 8. Now if it is possible, again we can simplify, otherwise we can multiply as it is. Now 7 into 25 divided by 2, we have to write it. If it is possible, we can simplify. Now we need to find the final answer, so we are going to multiply. We are going to divide. 1 2 is 2. 12.5. Now 7 into 12.5 is equal to 7 5s are 35, remaining 3. 7 2s are 14. 14 plus 3 is equal to 17, remaining 1. 1 7 is 7. 7 plus 1, 8. Now we have one decimal point, so one decimal point we made it. And 87.5% of notes my friend bringing to the school. So this is the way to find percentage, fractions to percentage. Next topic we are going to see, that decimals to percentage. Decimal to percentage. The first one, we are going to take 0.75. We are going to convert this decimal point into percentage. To convert into percentage, we have to multiply by 100%. Here 0.75 is there. To cancel this decimal points, 75 divided by 100. We are converting this decimal into fraction. 75 divided by 100. Because 2 decimal point is there, to cancel that, we are multiplying and divide by 100. So next, 100%. Now two zeros gets cancelled and the remaining is 75%. And next, if we are taking decimal number 0.09 into 100% is equal to, here we have two decimal points, so again we have to multiply and divide by 100. So 9 divided by 100, two decimal point is there, we multiply and divide by two zeros, so now 9 by 100 into 100%. Two zeros gets cancelled and the remaining is 9%. So this is the method to convert decimals to percentage. And next topic, the next important topic we are going to see, that profit or loss. Profit or loss, this is very important for the business purposes. Now first you will see that CP means cost price, that is buying price. Next, SP, sale price. If it is profit, definitely the selling price should be greater than the cost price. If it is profit, selling price should be greater than the cost price. And if it is loss, cost price is greater than the selling price. This is very important. CP is equal to cost price, SP is equal to sale price, profit. If it is profit, sale price greater than cost price. Loss, cost price greater than selling price. Now we will see one example. We bought a pen by 10 rupees. We are selling the same pen by 12 rupees. Now we will compare cost price, this is sale price, cost price, sale price. Here sale price is greater than the cost price, so that is profit. How much is profit? To find profit, we have to subtract sale price minus cost price is equal to, sale price is 12 minus cost price is 10, so profit is equal to 2 rupees is profit. Now we are going to see that loss. If you are buying a pen by 12 rupees, that is cost price, and we are selling the same pen by rupees 10, we have to find the difference. Here selling price, cost price, sale price. Cost price is greater than the sale price. So definitely that is loss. How much is loss? To find the loss amount, we have to subtract cost price minus sale price is equal to cost price 12 minus 10 is equal to 2 rupees. So loss amount is equal to 2 rupees. So this is the way to find profit or loss. And CP is equal to cost price, SP is equal to sale price. Next topic is simple interest. Simple interest is very important topic. We are borrowing money from the bank or from financial agencies. We are borrowing some money. After that, when we are repaying, we will add extra money. That is in the form of interest. So that only we are going to see it in this topic. Simple interest. How to find that? Simple interest. The first one, how much money we are getting, we are borrowing, that is principal. That is principal. For example, and this is called P. And we are paying extra money, that is interest. That is I. We are borrowing money, that is principal. We are repaying by extra money, that is interest. And amount, total amount, principal plus interest, P plus I. Principal plus interest is equal to total amount we are repaying. And there is a formula is there to find simple interest. To find simple interest, PRT divided by 100. The meaning of P, principal, R, rate of interest. P, principal, amount. Next one here, R stands for rate of interest. And next T, time, for how many years we bought it, that is time. P, principal, or rate of interest, T, time. By using this formula we can find the interest. For example, we are borrowing 10,000 rupees. This is P. P is equal to 10,000 rupees. And I bought it for 5% interest. Rate of interest is equal to 5%. And next time, I bought it for 2 years. We are going to find simple interest by using same. To find simple interest, SI is equal to PRT divided by 100 is equal to P, principal amount, 10,000 into rate of interest 5 into time 2 years divided by 100. Now 2 zeros gets cancelled. What is remaining? 100 is there. Into 5 2s are 10 is equal to, now 1 into 1 1 1 2 3 zeros are there. So I have written that 1000. Now simple interest is equal to 1000. This is interest amount. So how much should I pay, repay? Amount is equal to principal plus interest. Principal amount is equal to 10,000 plus interest amount is equal to 1000 is equal to 10,000 plus 1000 is equal to 11,000 rupees. So total amount I have to repay after 2 years 11,000. Okay, that's all students. Kindly give your suggestions in the comments box. Share this video to your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you.